Hi, Chen. I help you out. Find it home. In our last session, we learned the present tense and past tense. In this session, we shall learn the future tense. And we use future tense to express some future actions and the planned actions. Now, let us go in detail with the future tense. First one, simple future. So the simple future also is called future indefinite tense. This tense is used in the following ways. Simple future tense is used to say what we believe or think will happen in future. Example, I believe she will join the office tomorrow. They will go to the college. We shall win the match. And this future simple also is called for the things which we cannot control and are factual. For example, the sun will rise at 6 a.m. And simple future tense is also used to indicate an instant decision. For example, it is our first marriage anniversary. I shall give you a precious gift. So now what is the structure that we use to frame an affirmative sentence in simple future? The second and third persons, pronouns, you, he, she, it, they, plus, will plus, first form the verb plus, object, or the first person pronouns, I or we plus, shall plus, first form the verb plus, object. In future tense, we use shall with the first person pronouns I and we. And in future tense, we use will with the second person and third person pronouns he, she, it, and you, and they, and so on. For example, he will sell his house. I shall purchase a new car. And sometimes we frame some negative sentences in simple future. And the structure that we use to frame a negative sentence in simple future is second and third person pronouns such as you, he, she, it, they, plus, will plus, not plus, first form the verb plus, object, or the first person pronouns I and we, plus, shall plus, not plus, first form the verb plus, object. For example, my friend will not host dinner this evening. We shall not skip the exams. Now, let us see the rules for interrogative sentence in simple future. And when we frame interrogative sentence, we use will or shall plus subject plus first form the verb plus object plus question mark or question mark plus will or shall plus first form the subject plus first form the verb plus object plus question mark. Children, question mark also is part of the answer, so we should not forget or neglect to use the question mark in interrogative sentences. Here there are a few examples. First one, will she not come to the party? Who will help him? Why will your friend not come to it? Now, let us discuss future continuous tense. This future continuous tense is used in the following ways. First one, it is used to indicate an action that will occur in the normal course. Example, she will be cooking the food tomorrow. Next example, I will be meeting him tomorrow. And this future continuous tense also is used to indicate an action that will be in progress at a given point of time in the future. Example, at this time tomorrow, we shall be attending the party. And second example, we shall be visiting the zoo at this time tomorrow. Now let us see the structure how to frame the future continuous tense. Here, the second and third form of the pronouns such as you or he, she, it or they plus will plus be plus first form the verb plus inform plus object or the first pronouns I or we plus shall plus be plus first form the verb plus inform plus object. For example, next year my teacher will be going to China. Second example, I shall be teaching my students. So this is how we frame future continuous tense. Now, let us see how to frame a negative sentence in future continuous tense. To frame a negative sentence in future continuous tense, the structure that we use is, first, the second and third person pronouns such as you or he or she or it or they plus will plus not plus be plus first form the verb plus inform plus object or the first person pronouns I or we plus shall plus not plus be plus first form the verb plus inform plus object. Examples, they will not be studying in the city college. Second example, I shall not be bathing this evening. Now let us see the rules for interrogative sentences. The structure that we use to frame an interrogative sentence is like this. Will or shall plus subject plus be plus first form the verb plus inform plus object plus question mark or question verb plus will or shall plus subject plus be plus first form the verb plus inform plus object plus question mark. Example, will this boy be wandering in the forest? Second example, how long will they be traveling? Now, let us move on to future perfect tense. This future perfect tense is used to describe an action which will be completed at some time at some point of time in the future. For example, I shall have finished this work by tomorrow. Second example, they will have reached home by evening. Third example, I shall have reached the school before the bell rings. Now, let us see the rules for affirmative sentence in future perfect tense. Here, the structure that we use to frame an affirmative sentence is second and third person pronouns such as you or he or she or it or they plus will plus have plus third form the verb plus object or the first person pronouns such as I or we plus shall plus have plus third form the verb plus object. Example, your examination will have been over by Tuesday. Second example, we shall have cooked the food by the evening. Now, let us see the rules for negative sentences. Here, the structure that we use to frame negative sentences, the second and third person pronouns such as you or he or she or it or they plus will plus not plus have plus third form the verb plus object or the first person pronouns I or we plus shall plus not plus have plus third form the verb plus object. Here there are few examples. The first example, the passengers will not have reached the station before the train starts. Second example, your brother will not have read this novel before next Saturday. Third example, I shall not have written the letter by noon. Now let us see the rules for interrogative sentences. Here, the structure that we use to frame interrogative sentences is like this. Here we begin with will or shall plus subject plus have plus third form the verb plus object plus question mark or question verb plus will or shall plus subject plus have plus third form the verb plus object plus question verb. For example, will he not have gone before I reach? Second example, what will he have eaten before he sleeps? Now let us move on to future perfect continuous tense. This future perfect continuous tense is used in the following ways. It is used to describe an action that will be in progress for a period of time that will end in the future. Example, at noon, Anuradha will have been singing songs for an hour. Second example, I shall have been working round the clock for 22 years next April. Now let us see the structure to frame affirmative sentence. Here, second and third person pronoun such as you or he or she or it or they plus have plus will plus have plus been plus first from the verb plus inform plus object plus since or for plus object, or the first person pronouns I or we plus shall plus have plus been plus first from the verb plus inform plus since or for plus object. Here the example is like this. By next April, we shall have been leaving for the USA. Now let us see the rules for negative sentences. The structure that we use to frame a negative sentence is second and third person pronouns, you or he or she or it or they, plus will plus not plus have plus been plus first from the verb plus inform plus since or for plus object, or the first person pronouns I or we plus shall plus not plus have plus been plus first from the verb plus inform plus since or for plus object. Here there are two examples. Mahima will not have been going to Kanpur for a long time. Second example, I shall not have been waiting for half an hour. Now let us see the rules for interrogative sentences. The structure that we use in interrogative sentences, we begin with will or shall plus subject plus have plus been plus first from the verb plus inform plus since or for plus object plus object or question mark or question word plus will or shall plus subject plus have plus been plus first from the verb plus inform plus since or for plus object for question mark. And here there are two examples. Will she have been playing for some time? Why will you not have been going to school since 8 o'clock? Children, here there are few sentences for your home task. And you need to change these following sentences into future tense. And there are some clues also are given in the brackets, and you can use them in if required or where required. First one, I am throwing a party for my school friends tomorrow afternoon. Second sentence, my friend has many flowering plants in his garden next summer. The actress plays the role of an astronaut in space in her next film. You become the best dancer in the class soon. We wait for them at the station. Rahul goes to the dentist next week. We take care of our pets. I go for a haircut. Now what I want you to do is change these following sentences into future tense. Thank you, children.